Hello learners, are you one of them who fears mathematics? If yes, then this video is for you. Today I am going to tell you few tips which helped me to score 98 marks in maths, and following these you can score 100 marks too. So first tip for you is solve it daily. You have to solve maths daily or at least 5 to 6 days in a week, because you have to maintain continuity in maths. Okay, then next point for you is attend class very carefully. When you attend your class or watch any video lecture or go to any coaching, you have to listen to the teacher very carefully. Basically, this is the tip which is applicable for all subjects, but just now I am telling you about maths only. We'll discuss about next subjects in later videos, okay? And the next tip for you is you have to read the concepts from book and its summary very carefully. Yes, you heard it right. You have to read book. You have to read the concept from book, because sometimes it happens that one or two mark question directly come from book. Okay, so you have to read concept from book very carefully, and you have to read and make it short notes. You can make it short notes, or you can prefer from anybody, because making it can take your time. You can refer my notes I am also providing, or you can prefer from any other trusted source. It's totally up to you. And next point for you is solving sequence. It really matters that what you have to solve first, because if you directly jump to any tough question, you will feel that I am not able to solve that question. So after attending class, you have to read the book and make it short notes, and then you have to move to examples which are in your book. Okay, I am talking about which book? I am talking about your NCERT, or which is the main book your course follows. Okay, you have to move the examples of the textbook. Then after examples, solve exercise questions. And after exercise questions, go to any coaching material or study material which you want to solve. Okay, if you are solving any question, you are stuck into that question, then mark that particular question and see its solution. Okay, and after seeing its solution, you have to solve it by yourself again and again until you get that answer. Okay, and even after, if you don't get it, ask to your teacher or watch any video. It's all up to you. Okay, then next, a day you have to maintain only for revision. In a week or after 10 days or 15 days, whatever you like, but you have to maintain a day which you will devote only for revision. Okay, and next point is practice, which is the most important point. Practice. It is the most important, because without practice, maths is nothing. Okay, and then you have to make a formula notebook. You can make a small notebook and carry it with you always, and almost every place wherever you can take it. And I'm giving you tips wherever you can revise it. If you sit into your school bus and you take 15 minutes or 20 minutes to reach school, then you can revise that notebook sitting in that book, and or in school in interval time if you have free time, or you have break between two classes, or you can click pictures in your phone also of that formula wherever you go, anywhere with your family, and you are getting bored there, or any family functions, or anywhere. I am not pointing anything else. You can sit there. If you are getting bored, you can revise them. And next one bonus tip is that you can make the formula sheets and stick into in front of your study table or in your Godrej or anywhere, and have a look at it again and again. Okay, and next point for you is test. Keep giving test, especially in maths. It matters a lot. If you keep giving test, then you have the habit of solving it, and you will get more practice of it. Okay, then it's revise. What you have to revise when you move to any question, or when you are going to give any test, you can revise your theory concept, which notes you have made, or you have formula sheets. You can revise it, then after that solve. You will feel that you can solve the questions easily, okay? And put away. What things you have to put away? You have to put all the distractions away. Because when you are solving maths, your mind should be calm, okay? So you have to put your mobile phone or anything else which is distracting you. Or if you are studying in your mobile, then you have to use it very precisely or very carefully that you can't get distracted, okay? You can use focus mode for this. We'll discuss about it later. You can put away all the distractions, and one next tip is optional. You can make fair notes. It's optional, but it helps if you make it. Making fair notes will help you like this, that in fair notes, what you have to do is that you have to solve each and every question, or the question which is tough, or selected questions from each and every exercise, or all the questions in a very simplified manner, because it will help you when you study any question again and you are stuck in that. Then you can refer to that notebook in which you have solved each and every question in a simplified manner. So your time will not get wasted in watching again any video or going to teacher to ask it again and again, because time is very important, you know very well. And next, or the last point, is study sequence. In which sequence you have to study the chapters given in your maths book. Firstly, study the 1, 2, 3 or 4 chapters, starting chapters mainly. Then after that, study the weighted part of your book. Mostly it's trigonometry and calculus. You can study any, because when you study starting chapters, it relates with all the other chapters. And when you study weighted chapters, it will make your confidence that you are secured with at least these marks. Okay, that's all from my side.